And every time I have noticed improvement. We were here when a very sad incident happened, when we lost a chief here. I am happy and I want to thank you and the regional security team, Mr. Macau, the regional police boss and your team. I'm very grateful, DAP regional boss, and nawashukuru sana. Nyeri is now quiet, the leaders are happy, and wananchi are happy. Whatever work is left to be done, let's get on and do it. Because we are paid to make sure that the people of Kenya are secure and they are safe and their wealth and property are also kept safe. Thank you very much. I really appreciate your work. Secondly, I want to convey sincere regards and greetings from His Excellency the President to all of you good people in the central region of our country. I will shortly address a number of issues, some of which I am addressing because His Excellency the President personally demands that we address them, because he has received a lot of complaints from farmers and wananchi in this part of our country, and he has required of us that we address these issues immediately, and I will explain to them. This is very important, and we are doing this around the country. We are meeting all our deputy county commissioners and all our assistant county commissioners, because the 440 of the ACCs in the service now and the 3,400 chiefs who have not undergone paramilitary training will have to do that within the next 6 months, because the program is now ready. We are working with the DIG in charge of administration police, Mr. Gabo, and all of you, or any of you who have not gone through paramilitary training, together with the 3,400 chiefs who have not gone through paramilitary training, must do so within the next 6 months. We have capacity, we are ready to provide that support. And we realize that that will prepare you even better for the service that we require you to render as we go forward. Secondly, we are doing this training across the country because we want to make sure that we are clearly harmonized and effectively coordinated. We want to act seamlessly as the coordinators of national government. That is why I was in Embu the other day, I was in Kisumu 2 weeks ago, and after this I am proceeding to Garissa to meet with the regional security teams in the northeastern part of our country and then Coast Province, and we complete this exercise as it were. I'm going around the country working with all our security teams to ensure that we harmonize our approach to the delivery of services, we coordinate ourselves effectively, and we do the same thing in terms of how we administer and address our people. Now, the RC has addressed some of the issues, and Mr. Osia, our Secretary for National Administration, has also raised the same issues. If you are to summarize President Uhuru Kenyatta's philosophy of government, it is about two words: service delivery. That's why our president demands of us every day results. Have the people of Kenya felt that their government is serving them? The whole philosophy of our president's administration is about service delivery. If you look at it from the time he assumed the responsibility of running our country to date, from the establishment of Huduma centers, our president is focused on service delivery. That government is about service delivery. Because why do people have a government if they cannot get services? Why do people have a government if they have to strain to do certain things? People elect a government so that they can get services and they can be helped to go about their businesses and the things they do without undue strain. That is why our focus as national government, and this is the message I'm taking to each one of us across the country, we are about service delivery. And in looking at that, for us, you look at the second part of our title, Our ministry is called the Ministry of Interior and the Coordination of National Government. That bit about coordination of national government means we are responsible in our respective jurisdictions in coordinating the delivery of services by national government. We coordinate national government functions in our respective jurisdictions. Our regional commissioner chairs the regional security team, and all national government functions in the region are coordinated by our regional commissioner. And that is cascaded down to the county commissioners, the deputy county commissioners, the ACCs, to the chief, to the assistant chief, and it goes down that way. And for us to make the difference that we must, we have to be aware, again, as I said, that we are about service delivery. If people are not sleeping because they are terrorized left, right, and center, we have not delivered the service. If coffee farmers, as I'm going to talk about that shortly, in a very stern manner, if coffee farmers in the central part of our country, these farmers we have here who are complaining, peasants, people are writing memoranda to government to complain about theft of coffee in central region. If our farmers are not happy, we have not delivered service. If, for example, as Mr. Osia knows, we are investigating some of our own officers and working with some of our system to discipline some of our officers in two counties in the country, where we're asking questions, for example, if you are the county commissioner in a region where farmers are growing maize, who knows those farmers more than you do? So when quangles, thieves, and street thieves are lining up, importing maize from another country and bringing it to NCBB, where were you? How come you did not tell us as the county commissioner or the deputy county commissioner that my farmers have not been paid? Because our theory as national government administrators is that when you get to your sub-county, all those farmers, the 190 who are in that area, those are your people. Those are the people you live and die with. If they are dairy farmers, you work with the government officers who are rendering that service, you work with them. So if there's an outbreak of foot and mouth disease, who is supposed to know before anyone? It is you as the deputy county commissioner. And then you summon your ACCs and your chiefs and your assistant chiefs and work with them and tell them, hey, good people, our farmers have got a problem because soon they are not going to get a good yield and soon they will be destituted. So we must address their needs, as it were. So, my colleagues, don't forget about this. We are about service delivery, and it is our responsibility. We will not make excuses. We coordinate national government functions in our respective jurisdictions. So, I have come to deliver that message and tell you that that is how we interpret and must meet the demands or the requirements of the Commander-in-Chief, the Head of State, and the President of the Republic of Kenya. He insists it's about service delivery. And we in the security sector have to do it, but most importantly, we also have to coordinate, for those of us in Ngao, we have to coordinate the delivery of services across the board. So any national government program in your jurisdiction, Ata Barabara, Dam, now, when I see things that are saying that some people have been paid for a dam that is non-existent.
That is it.